When you start Progress Developer Studio for the first time, you need to specify a workspace location. A workspace is a folder in your file system where all your development project files reside. Each workspace is used by a single developer. A best practice is to physically locate your projects in the workspace folder. Here we specify the location for our new workspace. If you later want to share the projects and files in your workspace with another developer, you can export them. Once we have specified the workspace location, Developer Studio opens a welcome page. We click Workbench to open our new workspace. The new workspace is displayed and ready for use. The workspace shows the editor perspective. This perspective consists of a set of views and an editor that you'll use to work with your projects. Depending on your preferences, you can customize the workspace by adding and removing views and changing the layout. The OpenEdge Editor can be customized. For example, your development team may decide to standardize on specifying ABL keywords in lowercase. To customize how the OpenEdge Editor will work in our workspace, we use the workspace preferences and drill down to the Progress OpenEdge Editor settings. Here we see several settings. To specify that we want to use lowercase, we select the lower radio button, and then select both case keywords and apply keyword casing on save. As you can see, there are a number of other settings that can be customized. For example, expand keywords can be selected to set the editor to automatically expand keywords as you type. Another useful group of settings enables syntax checking features. To do this, I'll expand Editor and select Build Options. The Build Settings properties control what types of files are built and what happens when they are built. Here we customize what happens when ABL code is saved. We select Compile on Save if required, select all of the syntax checking settings, and we increase the number of errors that will be displayed when the application compiles from 100 to 200. Another useful setting is to display line numbers. Displaying line numbers makes it easier to communicate with other developers and will also help you debug your code. For this setting, you navigate to the General and Editors preferences, and then select Text Editors and check Show Line Numbers. We save the workspace preferences by clicking OK. Next, let's see how easy it is to import a project into a workspace. You typically do this when another developer has exported and provided you with a project. To import the project, you select Import from the File menu, and then navigate to General and select Existing Projects into Workspace. In this example, we're importing an archive file. The best way to export and import a project is to use a zip file. To import, choose Select Archive File, and then browse to locate the zip file. We select the customer app project archive file that we want to import into our workspace and select Finish to perform the import. After we've completed the import, the new customer app project appears in the Project Explorer view. It has two subfolders, Bin, which contains compiled code, and Source, which contains the source code. A development team should agree on naming conventions for the top-level folders for projects. Later, as we add code to our project, you may notice that nothing is displayed in the bin directory. By default, the compiled code, known as our code, is not displayed in the Project Explorer since developers typically don't work with these files during development. However, as with other areas of Developer Studio, you can customize which file types are displayed based on the file extension. If you want to see the compiled code in the project, you can select Customized View and then uncheck the filter for files with the R extension. The console view displays a message that the AVL virtual machine, or AVM, has started for this project. An AVM is a compile and runtime environment for ABL code. By default, every OpenEdge project in your workspace uses its own AVM. Whenever you import a project into your workspace, a best practice is to recompile your application One way to do this is by cleaning your workspace, which compiles all code in your workspace. In our case, notice that the red X appears in the source folder for the project where you can identify the file that has the error. The problems view displays workspace messages that are grouped by errors, warnings, and information. When you hover over an error, you can see more information about the error. In addition, if you double-click the error, the file where the error occurred is opened in the editor and the cursor is positioned to the line that has the error. Notice that the red X is displayed on the line where the error occurred. In this case, a period is missing from this ABL statement. An ABL statement must end with a period. After correcting the error, we save the source file. Based on the preference we set earlier, Developer Studio automatically compiles the code, and the error markers are removed. Now let's create an OpenEdge project from scratch. We open the Create OpenEdge Project wizard and name the project WinForms Client. If we select Client, we see that we can create three types of desktop applications or a web application. The client project types for GUI for .NET, App Builder, and Character are customized for these types of client projects. The code that we will import is a Telric WinForms application, which does not require a customized project type. Therefore, we select General and then take the default project type named OpenEdge Basic, which provides all of the support needed for our application. In the future, if you find your project does need to support additional features, this can be done by adding facets. We select Next. We want to use Source and Bin for the top-level project folder names, so we make the necessary changes. We select Finish to create the project. The newly created project appears in the Project Explorer view. We see the WinForms client project with the top-level folders Bin and Source. You can optionally create subfolders under Source and organize your application code. We create the GUI and adapter folders. You do not create subfolders under the Bin folder, as they are created automatically when you compile your code based on the directories in the source folder. To add existing source files to a project, you import them by dragging and dropping files from your file system using Windows Explorer into the appropriate project folders. Here we add an ABL class file to an adapter folder. A best practice is to always copy the files into your projects rather than to link to them. Next, we add the ABL form class file along with its resources to the GUI folder and add the Telric library assemblies to the project. And finally, we add the ABL procedure file to the top-level source folder. After adding these files to the WinForms client project, we see errors in the problems view. The errors you see when you copy files into your projects could be related to the order in which the files were copied. A best practice is to clean your workspace each time you copy a set of files into your workspace. Now let's look at using the OpenEdge editor. First, let's open the procedure file runclient.p. When you double-click a file containing ABL code, it opens a new tab in the OpenEdge editor. The outline view displays using declarations and variables defined in the procedure file. When you click on the item in the outline view, such as a variable, it takes you to that location in the editor. Now, let's open an ABL class file. The file we're opening is customer-ve-service-adapter.cls. We open that in the editor by double-clicking it in the project view. The outline view shows the properties, methods, as well as using declarations of this class. We now have multiple files open in our workspace. If you enable Link with Editor in Project Explorer, the file you are currently viewing in the editor is highlighted in Project Explorer so you can see its context within the folder structure of a project. You can turn off this feature by again clicking Link with Editor. Form class files, for example, a class representing a Telric WinForms UI, can be open in either OpenEdge Editor or Visual Designer. Visual Designer is used to add controls to a form, while the OpenEdge Editor is used to modify ABL code in the form. Here, we open the Get Customer Info class, a Telric WinForms file, first in the editor, then we open it in the Visual Designer. The same file opens in both views. In the OpenEdge Editor, you can expand and hide parts of your ABL source code to make the context of your code easier to understand. Creating an ABL procedure file or ABL class file is easy using the wizards provided by Developer Studio. To create a new procedure in the GUI folder, we right-click the folder and select New ABL Procedure. We name this file example.p and click Finish to create the ABL procedure file, which is opened in the new tab in the editor. The OpenEdge Editor uses colors to represent different elements of an ABL statement. As we type ABL code, the editor automatically completes keywords since we configured this preference in the workspace. Here we type an ABL statement to define an integer variable. Notice that there are different colors for ABL keywords, variable names, ABL data types, as well as constants, which appear in blue. You may find that you want to comment or uncomment your code. You can comment a single line of code by adding two slashes to the start of the line. Commented code is displayed in green. You can also comment a section of code by selecting the code and then selecting that you want to comment the source by selecting Source, Toggle Comment. In this video, we've been doing most tasks by selecting menu options. Most changes can also be done using keyboard shortcuts. For example, you can toggle between commenting and uncommenting code using Control Slash. Notice that there's an asterisk in a tab for runclient.p. This indicates that the program has been modified and that the changes have not yet been saved. If the ABL statement we type has a syntax error, we receive immediate feedback because we enabled syntax checking for this workspace. In addition, the marker bar on the right indicates each error in the file. This can be useful in larger files since the marker bar shows the relative position of each error in the file, and you can use it to position to that line of code by selecting the marker. Saving runclient.p clears the asterisk in the tab for that file and attempts to compile the code. Then compile errors appear in the problems view. After we correct the error and save the file again, errors in the problems view are cleared. We execute the code in the current procedure file by clicking the run icon. The form appears. When we click the button Get Customer to retrieve a customer name, a runtime error occurs. This is because the AVM for the WinForms client project cannot find the service interface folder, which is located in the customer app project. To fix this, we must modify the project properties for the WinForms client project, so that the compiled code of the customer app project is available to the client code. We open the properties for the WinForms client project. We navigate to the Progress OpenEdge ProPath properties and add the bin folder for the customer app project to the OpenEdge ProPath for the WinForms client project using Add Workspace directory. After this change is made, we can successfully run the application in Developer Studio. Clicking Get Customer now displays Center Sports. To close the OpenEdge Editor or Visual Designer view for a file, you simply close the tab. If there are modifications to a file that have not been saved, Developer Studio prompts with a message asking if the changes should be saved. This completes our introduction to Progress Developer Studio for OpenEdge. You've seen how to set up an ABL development environment, import and create projects and application files, and how to use the OpenEdge Editor perspective to work with ABL application code. To learn more about developing ABL applications, take the course Developing a Progress OpenEdge ABL Application.